Hi, everyone, and welcome to the 14th Annual Family Weekend Music Showcase. I'm Dr. Mark Reimer, Director of Music, the George and Mary Torgler Professor of Music, and Distinguished Professor of Music at Christopher Newport University. On behalf of President Paul and First Lady Rosemary Tribble, our dedicated music faculty and staff, and the over 400 incredibly talented student musicians, we extend to each of you our warmest welcome and invite you to join us as we celebrate in music our many blessings in life. Our theme for this concert is Let's Have Hope for Tomorrow, a celebration of life, joy, and optimism, the true spirit of Christopher Newport University. Despite our separation this past spring semester, our students never left us in spirit, and we're so grateful to finally be back together. Let's begin by hearing the dynamic marching captains under the direction of Dr. John Lopez. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome now members from the incredible and the second largest Division III marching band in America, the marching captains.
Ladies and gentlemen, under the direction of Dr. John Lopez, we proudly present a very small portion and socially distanced version of the 17th edition of your Christopher Newport University Marching Captains. The percussion techs are Scott Amon and Ron Johnson. The graduate assistants are Emily Abram and James Lehman. The color guard captains are Quincy Benning, Emily Peterson, and Vic Wen. And your drum majors are Reese Tunstall, Emily Lou Kidder, and David Davenport. Now, the marching captains, we kick off today's performance with a fanfare and our fight song. Go, Captains! Fans, it's time to jump to your feet because the marching captains are gonna rock you with Joan Jett's I Love Rock and Roll. We'll be right back. sergeant captains love to dance, but now they're going to show you how they burlesque.
That was fantastic, marching captains. You never disappoint. All right, now let's go to the Chamber Choir and University Chorale, who have been working so hard these past few weeks to present to you the beautiful work, Half Acre, composed by Dan Massey and arranged by Gregory Good. The composer writes, quote, "I was taken aback when I first heard the recording on the 2002 album, Rabbit Songs. Images of open fields and life in the countryside swarmed my head. Few songs have managed to have that kind of lasting impact on me, and I instantly imagined how gorgeous it could sound in a choral setting. The words of adventure and travel evoke feelings of bittersweet nostalgia, especially feelings of home." Ladies and gentlemen, we are so pleased to present to you now the always impressive Chamber Choir and University Chorale under the direction of Dr. John Irving as they team up to perform Half Acre by Dan Massey.
Torn from the
choirs, that was absolutely stunning. What a beautiful performance. All right, we are delighted to present to you now the Jazz Ensemble under the direction of Dr. Kelly Rossum. Our always enthusiastic jazz students will give us a spirited performance of Manteca, one of the earliest works of Afro-Cuban jazz. Manteca was composed by Dizzy Gillespie and Chano Pozo and is considered to be one of Gillespie's most famous recordings and the first tune whose rhythm is based on the claves. The work was premiered in 1947 in Carnegie Hall. Ladies and gentlemen, we present to you now the Christopher Newport University Jazz Ensemble and Dr. Kelly Rossum in their performance of Manteca by Dizzy Gillespie and Chano Pozo. What a fantastic performance, Jazz Ensemble. I felt like I was in Cuba. All right, we feature now the beautiful work, The Promise of Living, from the opera The Tenderland by Aaron Copland. The opera portrays a farm family in the Midwest in the period of the Great Depression and was premiered in 1954 by New York City Opera. Opera CNU will be performing the opera on November 6th and November 7th. We present now Opera CNU and their director, John McGuire, in their performance of The Promise of Living by Aaron Copland.
It promises to be a fine night.
Oh,
All right, that was beautiful, opera senior, and we look forward to your performance. The University Orchestra performs for us now that immortal work by Leroy Anderson, Plink, Plank, Plunk, composed in 1951. As a composer wrote, quote, "As a bass player, I got firsthand knowledge of the resources of a string orchestra and became particularly interested in the use of the pizzicato, which is very often neglected by composers. The string players have to lay down their bows and from the beginning to the end of the piece, pluck the strings of their instruments." Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome now the University Orchestra and its maestro, Dr. Jacob Tews, in their performance of Plink, Plank, Plunk by Leroy Anderson. Thank you, University Orchestra. That was so entertaining, and what a new sound for the orchestra. We feature now the wind ensemble, who will begin this final portion of our concert with an exceptionally spirited work, Clutch, by Andrew David Perkins. With his childhood memories of being with his dad at the racetrack in Detroit, the composer writes, quote, "The competitive spirit inspired me to write a fanfare that pushes the boundaries of tempo, range, and technical demand and gives the conductor, performers, and listeners a nice adrenaline rush. I also wanted to push myself to write the most exciting, wildly chaotic music that I could imagine. Fast, loud, and a little bit reckless." Gee, that describes the CNU Wind Ensemble. Thank you. Wow, that was a fast ride, wind ensemble. But now is the time in the program when I like to feature our trumpet section. Today, we will be performing that epic work made famous by trumpeter Maynard Ferguson, MacArthur Park. The work was composed in 1967 by Jimmy Webb and was inspired by his relationship and subsequent breakup with his girlfriend, who would occasionally have lunch with him in MacArthur Park. The composer writes, quote, "Everything in the song was visible. There's nothing in it that's fabricated. The old men playing checkers by the trees, the cake that was left out in the rain, all of the things that are talked about in the song are things I actually saw." And so it's a kind of musical collage of this whole love affair that kind of went down in MacArthur Park, end quote. Well, let's see what kind of love affair our trumpeters are having on stage today. Ladies and gentlemen, please enjoy MacArthur Park by Jimmy Webb and featuring our trumpet section and solo trumpeter Hayden Cameron. Thank you. No Family Weekend Music Showcase would be complete if we did not feature our incredible voice faculty. We feature today Dr. Rachel Holland, Director of Vocal Studies, who will perform Let's Have Hope for Tomorrow, a beautiful work by Japanese composer Satoshi Yagasawa. I actually had to contact the composer in Japan to get this work, and a very special word of thanks goes to Dr. Christopher Lowe for translating the text from Japanese into English. Dr. Holland, I believe we're ready.
Thank you.
We conclude our Family Weekend Music Showcase with the world premiere of the special arrangement by James Jose of Israeli composer Nurit Hirsch's work Sharat Devora, or Song of Deborah, performed here with soprano, strings, and wind ensemble. Nurit Hirsch is a highly celebrated songwriter, sort of the John Williams of film composers in Israel. Song of Deborah celebrates a military victory attributed to two incredibly strong women mentioned in the Old Testament, Deborah and Yael. Thank you, everyone, for sharing your afternoon with us and for all that you do to support our students, especially in these challenging times. And now, the world premiere of this special arrangement for winds, strings, and voices of world-renowned Nurit Hirsch's latest hit, Song of Deborah. Shalom.
Thank you.